So it feels like that's the principle
to apply.
I'm working with this month in mm-hmm. March of if you force something towards an end, you produce the opposite. But again, it arrives. It's arriving by core presence, not by
mm-hmm. right.
This month, I think I'm going to work with this principle.
Right. No, I don't think that you know what I mean? That was it.
Yeah.
You know, and it's interesting because two people did an experiment with that and they wrote a big monography about it or whatever it was, a contribution. And it was okay as an experiment, but I had the same impression, you know, that Silo always emphasized that action through the co-presence, that the principles work co-presently. They're not something that you decide to do.
Yeah.
They work there, they're around you, and they are around you. That is the interesting thing, and the more we study and the more we talk about it, the more alive that they become, the more around you.
And throughout a day, you can be working with many different ones.
Oh, you know. Every action, everything that we do, could be done in a certain way. I love the fact that the principles tells you clearly what you have to look for, that is unity.
Yeah.
And that's not a very difficult register for people, you know? You know when you're unity.
Yes.
You know when you're contradictory. It's not mysterious.
Uh-huh.
It's not esoteric. It's just like that, you know? And so the idea of accumulating acts of internal unity is really beautiful. You know,
it is a
beautiful thing because in a humble way, we can see that sometimes we have made progress. You know?
Yeah, and going back to the internal states, mm-hmm. you feel you're higher up the tree.
Right.
You're in the...
Yeah, because that's a much more interesting triangle.
The
resolution, degradation, tendency, frustration, deviation, and all that crap. Seriously, speaking, you know, much
to inhabit
better.
That world is a real.
Mm-hmm.
It's not that interesting.
So this is a one not to fall.
The one to generation.
From here to here.
Uh huh.
The degradation.
Yeah.
Yeah. I identify that one as self doubt, too.
Degradation.
Mm. It's not only degrading out, it's degrading in.
Yes.
So, I tell you, this is good. This is very beautiful. Lo no ordinario es el intento. What is not ordinary is the attempt or intent.
Yeah.
That's high vigil and normalized active. Generation app. That is what you were describing.
Right.
Very beautiful. From here up is science fiction.
That's pretty funny.
Beautiful. I love this material.
Good.
Yeah, very, very, very interesting. I'm going to study it
okay.
a little bit, and then we can interchange on our Thursday meeting.
Yeah.
Because it's great. It's a good one. It interests me quite a bit.
Yeah. It did me. I mean, it captured my interest, definitely.
Yeah, it did. You were very enthusiastic when I arrived, because you mm-hmm. just that night had
that night we discussed it.
Right.
Yeah.
So I got there at midnight. I got in at midnight and Kenneth had that message meeting the same day.
Right. It's funny because it's from the get-go. The central theme is to maintain yourself in the work bondadosamente, kindly.
Oh, that's what
That's what he says at the very, very beginning.
Yeah.
It's very well translated, whoever did the translation, Jorge.
No, that's Google, I think.
No kidding, Google. It's good.
Yeah.
So far. I didn't check, but that part was
maintain
perfect.
Yourself in the word kindly.
Kindly, right. And that's why I thought nobody uses that word
like
except
that.
Him.
Yeah.
And then I start thinking, well, this is, wow, this is really cool.
Yeah.
And then I realized silo, you know, see? Uh-huh. And then, but I thought that it was different. Anyway, it's my confusion. And this is the attitude that is producing the revelations, the intuitions, the premonitions, the type of phenomena that we cannot access in any other way. In the moment, in that that we get that recognition, a substantial modification happened inside, is what he said. You read this, right?
Uh-huh.
Wow. And he used the word substance very specifically. Concretely, there is a substance.
No, you know, I didn't read it. Because we haven't stopped moving yet.
If anyone study the hormones, you could measure the grams. It has a smell, a color, and a direction. Mm-hmm. This is pretty good.
Yeah.
You open a can of worms with me with
this
one.
Well, this is what I wanted. I mean, this is what I wanted to look at.
Well, we
time,
are.
You know.
We are.
You want to keep going?
Sure.
Please. Let's.
Oh, this is too good. And he says, there I am in the house of the generation. There, whatever is going to happen will depend a lot from the personal work of each one. If you are working with yourself, if not, will depend on the circumstances of the environment. If it is a habitual mechanical type, and then arrive to generation, but then a priest cross his path, and the priest offer a possibility, and then the person ends up in the church as if it was the same thing.
Yeah.
That's really interesting.
Yeah,
thing.
Some passing fancy right. Will.
Yeah, it's also when people say, oh, yeah, I am Buddhist.
Yeah.
Find a monk there and they go and do all sort of exercise and they tell you, oh yeah, we're in the same thing. But if you are in an internal work, one has to take advantage of this particular point to try to take off and grow internally, to modify behaviors and to modify ambits. Is it that the take off needs the intent need is it like the take-off that we need in the intent is a take-off of behavior? It's a question open, apparently.
Mm-hmm.
You left the regression, right? The regress.
Right.
You arrived through remorse, and now you are in the tendency. Tendency to get out of the regression, tendency to break with that scheme. But more than anything, you are in front of your failure in your life. You don't have a job, you don't have a couple, you don't have, you know, a degree, or you have everything, but everything is being really bad with you. And then either or you go down through the conservation and you tell yourself, okay, it's good, but I'm going to try to change. In other words, you want to go up, but you're going to have to consider that you're going to go up with all the heavy things that you have done in your life. Or you said, no, not there, there is no exit. That doesn't mean that you are not going to keep working, that you're not going to do probably get involved with another girl or another couple, but you are taking off. You realize that there is not the solution of your life.
Mm-hmm. That's a very good one.
Mm-hmm. You cannot blame others for the condition of your life. When you assume this is when you assume your failure. And then none of those things will have the charge that they had before. And there you are in the road of frustration. That allows you to get to the zone of the deviation or displacement, I think that it was called. And then either you assume the resolution and you go forward with exclamation mark, and there I am in the generation, and now I have to decide what I do with my life.